The crowd is assembled at the American Airlines Center looking for a Mavericks win here in downtown Dallas. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. DA will join us tonight on the sideline. The Clippers looking for a strong start to this road trip. They just haven't been able to buy a break lately. Five of their last six games have been losses.
You know, sometimes during the season, Kevin, as long as it is, teams just go through that blasé period. And that's basically what I sense is going on here. You can't put a finger on any one or two things. It's just a matter of it not clicking and trying to figure it out.
All right, let's set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. So for the Clippers right now, Harris and Gortat are up front. Bradley and Gallinari are the wingmen. And it's Gilgeous Alexander in at the one spot.
Yeah, Jordan is aggressive as a rebounder. He uses his massive body, athleticism, and long arms to wreak havoc on the glass.
Now, here is Gallinari. Well, we're getting into the grinded out part of the season, Clark. Should we expect rookies now, you think, to start feeling the length of the NBA season right about now?
You know, that varies from individual to individual. I know when I was a rookie, it happened for me probably after about the 40th game or so. And I just was flat. I was still putting up decent numbers, but I just felt flat. I felt lethargic. And then all of a sudden, after a week and a half or so, it just kind of went away and finish that rookie season strong. So every rookie's different. Some rookies never hit the wall, Kevin, but most do in some form or fashion.
And teams are all on top of this, aren't they? I mean, they know there's a chance it's going to happen, so they prepare accordingly.
Yeah, exactly. And again, it's rare when a rookie doesn't hit it, but for some it might be an extended wall. For others, it might be a short wall.
Really just struggling here in the first few minutes. Five attempts with only one falling.
Hey, get that weak stuff out of here. Take it home. Jordan is fantastic at rejecting those kinds of shots.
Now, here is Smith after Gortat's miss. The kick out to Barnes. It's good, the assist that time from Smith. Barnes has got himself on the board with three there.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Yeah, Kevin, I was able to talk with Doc Rivers a few minutes ago. Having split the two games so far this season, coach told me he wants his team to be a little looser on offense. He said in the loss, we were static, overthinking each time down the floor. I'd prefer a more free-flowing approach tonight. We'll see if that extra freedom offensively works out, Kevin. Back to you.
All right, thanks for the report, David. So it's all about getting their offense going early on.
And I think that's the right call, guys. Get that rhythm established at the offensive end as soon as possible.
Yeah, I echo that, Greg. I mean, if they come out here as the aggressors and really get after it, I think it'll make things that much easier on them defensively.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander after Wesley Matthews' score. Now here is Harris. He's coming off a 28-point game against Golden State.
And don't forget about the work he did on the boards. His rebounding was a huge help in that game.
And it's Gortat finishing it off.
Boy, and the wingspan of Gortat, Kevin, helps him big time on the glass. Great at using his height and length to corral rebounds.
Now, here is Smith. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. No good on the shot. And it's the Clippers taking it the other way.
And, you know, by all accounts, last season was a fine debut for Dennis Smith Jr. I mean, he handled starting point guard duties from day one and was given room to learn on the job. Wasn't always easy, but this kid has talent and showed moments where you get an idea of how special he might be.
Bradley can't get it to go. Mavericks leading by three. Nobody near Barnes. And he gets the friendly spin, and that one drops. Barnes has got five.
Hey, when you lay off of Harrison Barnes, he's going to go right up on the catch.
And the Clippers decide to take their first timeout here. And for Smith last season, the goal was mostly to improve his game along with the teams.
Yep, exactly. And Dallas knew they wouldn't be competing for a lot and let Smith Jr. find himself, play through mistakes, learn on the fly. He improved his reads off pick and rolls and also showed improved vision as the season wore on. Guys at the point have to see the whole court at all times. One area, though, he's got to improve in is his defense and awareness on that end of the floor, because the athleticism is there. If the awareness improves, this guy could be a demon on D.
Harris kicks to Powell. Passes it to Nowitzki. Off target from three-point range. Clippers trail by three. Williams with a clean look. Can't tie it up as that one's no good. Now, here's Doncic. He's guarded by Williams. Pass to Nowitzki. Buries it from three-point range. Nowitzki's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball. Los Angeles has gone 0-2 from deep here. 50 seconds left to play in the... And stolen by Harris. Here's Doncic. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Yeah, the versatility and competitive fire of Doncic is impressive. You can just tell this kid loves to play the game. And looking at Luka Doncic, incredibly mature for his age. Physically, the broad shoulders, weighing in about 230. Mentally, though, advanced understanding of how to play the game.
Now, gentlemen, two shots. Loose shots.
First free throw is good. So after making the first, he goes one for two. Two for one opportunity here if they want it.
And no doubt, Kevin, if I'm them, I go for it.
And again, no good by the Clippers. And so it's Harris who will bring it up for Dallas. 17 seconds left here in the first quarter. Powell, the pass to Doncic. Over Harrell. And out of bounds as Los Angeles gains possession.
And that's just carelessness there. I mean, you have got to have your head in the game.
Williams with the ball. Shoots over Doncic. Los Angeles with another miss. He knocks it down, but wait a minute. The officials are getting together. They may want to review this one. And indeed, they're going to look at it again. They need to be certain he beat the buzzer.
And they're making sure on this one, even though it may not matter in the grand scheme, but the replay process is faster than ever. You know, why not?
Yeah, the replay center in Secaucus is providing the officials with the necessary footage to make the call. We're seeing what they're seeing with the best possible angles.
And they're keeping the call as is. It was close, but he had not released it before the clock had expired.
Yeah, still better safe than sorry. I think they did the right thing to take another look at it. And if it's so close that you can't tell by the naked eye, I might as well go to the slow-mo.
And so it's the Dallas Mavericks bringing the quarter to a close with a 7-point lead. They've been playing some ferocious defense. We've got more in store for you right after this. It's been a storied career for Dirk Nowitzki, but as he ages, he says he's spending a lot more time getting his body prepared to play.
Jay Kidd sort of tried all sorts of things when he was here. He was older, and, you know, he got massages right before the games and the stretching and all that. Now I'm in the same shoes. You know, I do all that stuff now, and you almost do as much off the court as you practice on the court.
A lot goes into holding off Father Time, but Father Time, by the way, is undefeated.
Yeah, and retirement's something he's considered for a few summers now, but he's making the most of his Hall of Fame career, savoring every last minute.
And hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far, halfway through the first half in this one. And what do you think, guys, about Dallas here in this one?
Just playing suffocating defense. That's been the difference here for them.
You know, Greg, I love watching this team get after it on defense. I mean, they play with a bit of edge and nastiness.
And the Clippers, looking at who they've got, Beverly and Williams, the guard tandem. Marjanovic is out there with Montrezl Harrell. and it's Scott in at the three spot. From the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, the Clippers have hit the reset button, and you wonder how that affects their head coach, Doc Rivers. Now, he seemed reluctant to lead a rebuild with the Celtics, but he's on board doing it with the Clippers. Even though the Clippers relieved him of his title of president of basketball operations in 2017, Rivers has just signed a new extension that will keep him coaching the team for the next few years. Kevin?
Well, if nothing else, D.A., he has guided them through some pretty dark hours. Thank you. Here's Doncic, and foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. Clark, when you're evaluating young players, and you see a lot of them at the college ranks and certainly in the early years in the NBA, aside from their talents between the lines, which qualities tell you this kid has a chance to be special?
A couple of things. Humility, understanding their ability, but also recognizing they've still got work to do. That's one of the great qualities anybody can have. Work ethic, self-starting. And then you try to see if, in fact, they've worked through some challenges. How have they handled adversity? I mean, when you look at those things and couple them with talent, now you've got somebody that you feel like can be special.
And he makes the first. Gallinari, he's checked in for Mike Scott. Both shots good from the stripe. A minute and a half gone here in the second quarter. Williams kicks to Marjanovic. The pass to Harrell. Harris against Beverly. Pass to Marjanovic. It's rebounded by Dallas. They couldn't put the pieces together, losing that last matchup with San Antonio.
And really, man, they played their hearts out. Missed a couple opportunities down the stretch, and that was the difference.
Yeah, you know what, Greg? Much love to them because the energy was there. But the execution fell just a little short.
And Doncic gets it to go.
And if you're the guy who has to guard him, it is never going to be an easy night for you.
On the wing, Williams. Scoring-wise, he's definitely making his mark right now. He's averaging about 19 points a game.
You know, Kevin, his team is struggling a bit right now. I mean, I hope he can find his rhythm and start making his shots out there soon. Otherwise, dot, dot, dot.
Harris outside. Lock at six. From deep. Another three for Dallas.
A much better quarter for them shooting the ball.
Anytime your field goal percentage is in the high 50s, partner, you're doing something right.
Los Angeles calls timeout. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Warriors.
Yeah, their last outing was a rough one. Have to be careful of falling in love with that three.
And you know what, Greg? You can't afford to be a one-function offense. You know what I mean? You've got to be versatile. Got to spread it out and mix it up inside, too.
And the Mavericks will go for a different look here. DeAndre Jordan's checked in for Powell. Harrison Barnes comes in for Dorian Finney-Smith. Wesley Matthews checked in for Doncic. And it's Dennis Smith in for Harris. And then for Los Angeles. Gortat's checked in for Harrell. Bradley comes in for Lou Williams. And Gilgeous Alexander is subbed in for Patrick Beverly. And it's Smith missing. Clippers trail by 12. Gallinari attacking. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. Harrison Barnes picks one up. The Clippers shooting their first free throws of the game.
And how about as a group, 80% on the season, one of their best attributes.
Guys, that says a lot about the poise of this team. I mean, they've been so calm, cool, and consistent at the stripe this year. I mean, that's impressive.
And the first one at the line is good. Where you look at player contracts today, Clark, a little different from the one after you signed your rookie year. What, 4 years and $1 million? Do I have that right?
Yeah, you got the numbers right, Kevin. And you know, I look at that as all relative. How about the guys who played way before me?
Right.
And they were traveling on trains to games and were working jobs during the summer. I mean, it's all a function of the revenue generation of the league, which has grown exponentially. Since I played, we were part of the group group that actually saw the first salary cap instituted in the early 80s. So growth is part of what we see now in player salaries, and I'm all for the guys to get what they deserve from that standpoint.
And when he gets in his head that he's going to get to the basket, very little you can do defensively.
Kicks to Harris. Over Barnes. Harris's shot is off. Mavericks leading by 12. Matthews with it. Now guarded by Gallinari. Matthews scanning the floor. Barnes against Bradley. And that one's good. Barnes.
Can't allow Barnes that kind of good position in the post, because once he has it, it's dinner time.
Passes it to Gortat. Over Jordan. Los Angeles with another miss. And so it's Smith with it. He'll bring it up for Dallas. Last time they came together was in Los Angeles, where they fell to the Clippers.
And they lost a close one last time they saw each other. And you have to think that it was the foul trouble that really kept them from getting the win.
And, you know, as you said, Greg, when you are in foul trouble, it makes you less aggressive defensively. And when that's the case, it's hard to offer the kind of resistance that you need to. That was in the back of the mind, the foul trouble they were in.
Dallas has gone 3 of 5 from beyond the arc so far tonight. To the inside and stolen by Harris. Now the feed to Bradley. Shoots over Matthews, and it's Bradley. That time on the assist from Gallinari. Bradley's got his first points of the game. Mavericks leading by 14. Smith kicks to Barnes. Over Gortat. Barnes can't get it to go. The Clippers shooting 27%. The offense is just embarrassing themselves. We've got 13 seconds left to play here in the second quarter. Pass to Harris. And it's sent back by Nowitzki.
And, you know, Nowitzki is capable of 86ing these shots now. That means rejection, using his height and wingspan to deny.
And so it's the Dallas Mavericks sitting with a comfortable lead up by 14. What a night they've had in terms of their shooting. Everything dropping in for them. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. Harrison, a strong first half for you guys defensively. What has worked at that end?
We're trying to be active. You know, this is a very good team. They've been shooting the ball really well from three, so we're just trying to run them off the line.
So far, so good. Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of action following halftime.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, Hoop fans. NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. EJ, Shaq, Jet.
Dallas has the edge here at halftime. They lead by 14. Kenny, what's your take?
In terms of their offensive performance, that was a very well-played half of basketball. Good ball movement off the ball, hard screens being set, and they found the guy for the open look. That's how they were able to shoot such a tremendous percentage from the field. With that fluid, efficient offense, they'll be tough to catch in the second half.
And over to Shaq. Now your take on the Clippers.
Well, they gave up too many good looks. You look at the field goal percentage against them, this tells the whole story. Not enough activity defensively, not enough disruption, Ernie. Like, Kenny disrupts me all the time. Not enough disruption.
And that's a wrap. With the third quarter approaching, we now send you back to Kevin and the crew.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. One of the stories here, Harrison Barnes getting it done today.
His points production thus far, off the charts. It's only been two quarters, just a great effort for him for the entire half.
Yeah, and it doesn't matter where he is on the floor either, Greg. He's making it look very easy. He's looking to score the ball.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it has been a runaway. Doncic and Barnes are the forward pair. Smith and Matthews in the backcourt. And it's Jordan in at the five spot. So that's who Rick Carlisle starts the second half with.
A slight rebound advantage for them. One more column in their favor, and it's all adding up.
Well, you take a look at all of the stats, the team stats, that is, and that's one of the many areas that they've had the advantage. And as a result, they've got a big lead.
And for Harrison Barnes, the scoring forward out of UNC said he wants to model his game, Clark, after Paul Pierce.
Hey, that's not a bad guy to look to model your game after, boy. Paul Pierce knew how to get it done, and he wasn't overly athletic, but he knew how to play angles. He could get to his spots, and he was such a great mid-range shooter who developed into a consistent three-point threat as well. So I like that comparison or that aspiration for Harrison Barnes.
Gallinari against Barnes. Inside, Harris makes it off the glass.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
Dallas leading by 12. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, guys, the Clippers are going in a new direction. Now, Coach Doc Rivers said, "We had a shot. I don't think anybody understands how hard it is to win a title. Until you do that, you're going to be frustrated a lot and have to make tough decisions." Kevin?
Well, they're trying to make the right decisions to rebuild better than before, D.A. Thanks. A different look for Dallas. Powell, he's checked in for DeAndre Jordan. Dorian Finney-Smith comes in for Barnes. And Harris subbed in for Smith. Lou Williams has checked in for Los Angeles. Here's Doncic. He has seven. Finney-Smith kicks to Matthews. Six to shoot. Let's it go from 14. And that one goes long.
And they're 1 of 4 here to start the second half.
That's it, and the Dallas lead is cut down to just 10 points on the bucket from Lou Williams.
And you know what, Kevin? As a defender, you think maybe you can intimidate Williams. Wrong. No way.
Doncic with it. Now guarded by Gallinari. Finney-Smith passes to Matthews. Dallas again missing.
Tell you what, shooting 20% to start the second half doesn't bode well for how this will play out for this squad.
Gallinari finds Williams. Good ball movement here by the Clippers. He gets it to fall. That makes it just a single-digit lead. Williams has got four this quarter.
A nice start to the second half. Just one miss in their first five attempts.
Now the pass to Finney-Smith. Now here's Matthews. Gortat covering. Basket counts. Matthews has got his second bucket.
And Matthews unafraid to let it fly from the mid-range now. A consistent score from this area of the floor.
And the Clippers call time here. Clark, there was a rules change not too long ago that promoted more help defense, less one-on-one defense. Good or bad?
I like it. Again, there's always going to be a premium on defending one-on-one, but positioning defenders where you can help better and more, I think it's trying to make sure the offensive side doesn't get too much of an advantage where the rules have gone in the past. So I think it's a nice balancing act for the game.
Maxi Kleba, he's checked in for Dallas. The Clippers also changing it up. Marjanovic checked in for Gortat. Harrell comes in for Gallinari. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Gilgeous Alexander. Williams attacking. Pass to Marjanovic. Another shot. Kleba with the rebound. Dallas leading by 10. To the paint. Powell dishes to Doncic. And the basket is good. Doncic has got 9 points.
And certainly not lacking in confidence. When Doncic gets these inside looks, he just jumps all over.
Here's Marjanovic. Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game. Here's Williams. The shot, no good. So the Mavericks will take it the other way. At one point, they led by 16. And he comes up with the deuce.
And Powell doing a nice job using his length on these hard shots. I mean, excellent at powering through the contact.
Harris against Beverly. Harrell kicks to Beverly. On the wing, Williams. It's rebounded by Dallas.
You know, he's been off so far, Kevin, but there's still time. I mean, he just needs to settle it down, idle it down a little bit, and try to contribute as much as he can on the offense within himself.
The Mavericks shooting their fifth and six free throws of the game.
And they've been ordinary on the season as well, just about 75% from the line.
And guys, that allows their opponents to play very aggressive defense if they choose to, knowing it's not a bad thing to send them to the foul line.
That free throw, no good. On the Mavericks with some changes. Nowitzki comes in for Dwight Powell. And Smith subbed in for Harris. Scotty's checked in for the Clippers. And he's good on the second. Clippers trail by 15. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Harrell, the pass to Williams. He feeds it to Beverly. He kicks it to Harrell. Williams, that's a two-pointer. Williams missing again.
Not a whole lot going down for him at this point. He just can't buy a break.
Passes it to Smith. Here's Doncic. Pass to Kleba. For three, Smith. A three-pointer is right on target. Smith's got five now.
Man, like to see Smith operate under pressure because he doesn't panic. I mean, he finds ways to score even in tight bailout situations.
Los Angeles calls timeout. And you know, Dennis Smith Jr. is a player who just is oozing with confidence when you see him play.
Yeah, I just love how Smith Jr. will attack every player he goes up against. Chris Paul, who Smith Jr. goes way back with, noticed how even as a rookie, he approaches every challenge head on. As a rookie, Smith Jr. was just jawing at the vets and dunking on everyone. He has the game to back up that personality.
Looking at who's out there now for the Mavericks. Jordan comes in for Maxi Kleba, and it's Barnes in for Dorian Finney-Smith. 6 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Barnes against Bradley. And he could not get that one to go. What a contact, and he'll go to the line for two.
And I think Barnes is an impressive athlete, Kevin. I used to say that for a lot of guys in this league, but he excels at reading the defense and forcing the issue.
The first free throw is good.
And, you know, Harrison Barnes is an effective two-way player, becoming better every day on offense and can defend multiple positions as well.
Barnes hits them both. 15 seconds left in the third. And here is Williams. 6 points for him. And there's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen.
Yeah, still moving a little bit when he set that screen. He'll argue that he was set, but I really didn't think so.
It was very close, and I wouldn't mind letting them play on that one. It wasn't blatant by any means.
And it's been about that execution offensively. I mean, they have been superb.
Yeah, and you know, the ball moves faster than anybody's can, so that great ball movement and decision-making, they're making all the right moves, Greg.
And so it's Dallas, sitting on a 21-point lead to end the quarter. The scoring has been tremendous, and they are shooting lights out with very high accuracy. We'll take a quick break, and then back to the action here. Now let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Yeah, and with the accuracy to go along with that vision. I mean, he put the ball in the absolute perfect spot. That's how you orchestrate it.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same from the first three quarters. And the Clippers, looking at who they've got, Bradley and Gallinari are the wingmen. Scott is out there with Harrell, and it's Beverly in at the point. Puts up a three. DeAndre Jordan grabs the miss. Jordan's got 10 rebounds here tonight. So active. To the middle, here's Smith. And they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
There's been a change in his game compared to what we saw in the first half. I mean, he's scoring with a lot of confidence now.
And what do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for the Mavericks?
You know, one of the big stories has been the three ball. It's been a key part of their offense throughout the game.
Yeah, I mean, they've also done a great job of playing in space, getting out in transition every opportunity.
Mark, an interesting aspect of the one-and-done controversy. Increasingly, these guys are being asked to take on a big role in the NBA right away.
Yeah, exactly. And you know what? I'm all for guys that have the unique ability and opportunity to play pro basketball out of high school or after 1 or 2 years of college. I would love to see college kids hang around for 2 or 3 years, but that's not realistic for the supremely gifted. But it does put pressure on your teams if you're expecting these young guys to come in and impact winning right away. It takes a little time, most cases, for even really highly talented players to become winning NBA players.
Nowitzki outside. Back to Smith. Dallas moving the ball around. No good from Jordan.
Excellent concentration from the deep. Intimidated the shooter, bothered him, distracted him, and made him think twice as he went in for that layup.
He gets that one.
I'm always appreciative of the aggressive mindset. Get it down in the paint and go to work with confidence.
Matthews finds Smith. Shoots over Scott. 11 feet out and he hits it.
This is a fantastic performance in this half. He didn't play as well in the first, but you just know with this guy, he's always ready to turn it around.
And that one's good by Gortat.
And it's all about the release when you shoot the floater.
Smith, the pass to Matthews. Average value of an NBA team, Clark, over $1 billion. And I can't even believe I'm saying that, but the league wasn't always so healthy and always thriving the way it is now.
Yeah, every business goes through periods of prosperity and challenge. The league, NBA, no different. Early 80s, there were real struggles and challenges. Then there was a real bump as we got into the late 80s and into the 90s, plateaued a bit, and now we're on a great ascension. But the players and the league have really worked well together to bring the league to a greater level of popularity and success in this time period now. And you can't discount the big money from TV contracts. That fuels the fire quite a bit as well.
And there's the call on DeAndre Jordan. That is his first foul of the game. And the Mavericks making a change here. Finney Smith's checked in. And Los Angeles making a change here as well. Harris has checked in. We're in the final quarter of play here. 3 minutes in. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Los Angeles with another miss.
The defense was less than impressive there, but despite them not really contesting that shot, he still bricked it.
Smith kicks to Matthews. Now, here is Smith. He's guarded closely. 5 on the clock. Shot from 12. It's hauled in by the Clippers. Gortat's got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done.
Gallinari surveying the D. Goes back up. Gallinari on the wing. Well, it was only a matter of time, but they finally get the bucket. Gallinari's got 4 points in the quarter. Now Smith. Clark, when you were playing to complement your inside game, you had that wonderful mid-range jumper, but more and more, players are going away from it.
I think it's all driven by analytics, Kevin. I mean, everything is about the three-point shot, efficiency of your possessions, go for three when you can or get it to the rim. And that makes sense from a mathematical standpoint. From a game standpoint, though, if a quality shot is a mid-range shot for a good shooter, I think you should take them all the time. I mean, that would just be my posture. So I differ with the analytics. I understand what they say. But if I was coaching, guys get a good mid-range jumper from a quality shooter, we're shooting it every time.
And tonight's battle is going to end with a very clear winner, leaving nothing to chance. Impressive win for the Mavericks.
Tonight, they seem committed to the three-point shot.
That was the bread and butter. Fortunately, they made enough of those, but sometimes it was quantity over quality.
And I think a great job in positioning themselves for the W here. It's win number 21 on the season. And while there was some nice performances tonight, it definitely ended up being a solid outing for Jordan.
Now, he was a problem on the glass today, relentlessly crashing the boards and came away with a bushel basket full of rebounds.
Bradley against Barnes. From 10 feet out, it's hauled in by DeAndre Jordan.
And being that close to the hoop, I thought he had enough room to finish that one.
And it's Barnes slamming it down.
I'll tell you what, the energy in this arena, you can feel it.
Big time. I mean, it's amazing. Their crowd letting them hear it. And that's always inspiring. They want to see this thing get wrapped up.
Now, here is Smith. So, no problem for Dallas as they get the win. They won this game going away. They were the better basketball team by far tonight.
And you got to commend this sort of dominance, particularly here at home. It's a great feeling when you play almost a perfect game and to have that crowd be so pumped up.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks, Kevin. Wesley, nice win after the last loss. How important is it to win these home games?
We need all of them. We need every single home win we can get. And like you said, it was a good bounce back win for us. And we got to get ready for our next game.
Great job, Wesley. Thanks again. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for being with us. So long.